Hey everybody, Chad with Nobody Else's Auto. Thanks for stopping by Nobody Show tonight. Check out what we've got going on, because we're in Myrtle, South Dakota at the Pioneer Auto Show. Tons of cool cars here. Almost 300 cars, signs, tractors, toys, guns. Extremely diverse collection. Tons of cool stuff. Obviously, we like cars. We're going to show you some cool cars. Shooting a lot of footage here today. Be sure to stay tuned. Tons more cool stuff coming up. No way to show you all this stuff. As we kind of scan this building here, you can see a lot of cool stuff in just this one building. We're bringing some highlight vehicles here and there, catching two or three at a time in some different spots, but so much cool stuff here. You've got to put Myrtle, South Dakota on your list next time you're out on the road. Another one we're going to check out today, 1963 Buick Riviera. These cars have really, really come into their own lately. Super iconic design, groundbreaking design, always been a beautiful car, but I don't feel like they ever really got their just credit until here recently. And these cars have really been coming on strong in the market. Now, one other thing about the Pioneer Auto Show here, they do sell things. This particular Riviera is for sale. It's got a for sale sign right on it. So they do sell some of these cars. If there's something you're interested in, you can always talk to Dave about it. But plus they have cars outside that are for sale as well. So something don't count out. If there's something you're really interested in, you could may end up have a possibility of taking it home. This Rivy right here is for sale. It's a beautiful car. And like I said, these are such an iconic design. These cars have great lines on them. They were a luxury sport coupe is what they were designed for. We can take a peek inside of this one. See how these cars were equipped, you know, bucket seats, full length console. Back in 1963, these were gorgeous cars and definitely a statement for personal luxury back in the day. Nothing like them on the market. Great lines, and they really stood out as a very unique car. Right next to the Rivy, something else you don't see yet very often, 1966 Rambler Marlin. Great looking cars. Sun Valley Mercury beside that, and the road goes on and on and on. Next to the Riviera, though, the next one we're going to take a look at, 1947 Chevy Fleetline. Cars are super popular. These are a great design. This car checks all the right boxes. It's got the outside sun visor on it. It's got the accessory hood ornament on it. Good looking car, and something, and what makes these cars so popular is this roof line is such an iconic design. Obviously, we see the roof line start here at the top of the windshield with the exterior sun visor on it. And this roof line does not stop until we basically get to the back bumper. Iconic design for the late 40s. They really stood out. I guess these actually came out in the early 40s with this body style. But these are great looking cars. They're super popular, and that's why. They are unique. People like them. And this car is a great looking car. Next one we're going to check out, kind of tucked back here in the corner, a little tough to see. These cars have really, really gotten, are starting to get the respect they deserve. I personally love station wagons, huge fan of station wagons. The Buick Sport Wagon and the Oldsmobile Vista Cruisers, these cars are so awesome. They've got one tucked back here in the corner. Car is completely original and it is beautiful. Paint's a little bit faded, but man, this car is straight. It is clean. It's kind of a light blue. And obviously, being a Vista Cruiser, same as the Buick Sport Wagons, the iconic glass roof. These cars were so neat, so unique. Luggage rack, front roof window, side roof windows. These cars are so cool. They're getting so hard to find. Most people didn't show wagons much respect for a lot of years, but these things have really come into their own. We'll open the door here and take a peek up inside. Let's see if we can see up into that roof. And it's so neat to see wagons coming on. I'm a huge fan of wagons. I've always loved wagons, but a lot of these cars just weren't saved. You know, they were parted out, front clips used on 442s, things like that. They never really got the credit they deserved, but finally these wagons are starting to come on. And it's exciting to see. So seeing a nice, clean, especially an actual Vista Cruiser with the original glass roof, always kind of exciting. So, like I said, tons more stuff, cool stuff to come from here. Stay tuned. We're going to shoot a lot of videos here today, but with almost 300 cars on the property, no way we can show you everything. We're going to show you a few bits and pieces here and there. If you're anywhere in the area, be sure to put Myrtle, South Dakota on your list. The Pioneer Auto Show, great facility, awesome collection. You definitely don't want to miss it. Stay tuned. More cool stuff coming from Myrtle, and we'll see you soon on the next video.